Now, Connie Simpson, we're going to play another game. And if you're ready, we'll bring on another player. Here is Evie Phineas. Now, Evie, would you please tell us a little bit about yourself? Or tell us a lot about yourself.
Stretch it out. Tell us a lot.
Tell us a lot. You know what they're laughing at? I'll tell you what they're laughing at. Just as I said,
Texas.
Tell us a little bit about yourself, Evie. The producer came up and did that, which in television parlance means stretch it out. So I said, tell us a lot about yourself. In the meantime, our time is up, Evie. So we have no. What would you like to say, Evie?
I'm married, and I have two children.
Yep.
I'm sorry, darling, that's wrong. Thank you anyway.
Well, how old are your kids?
8 and 2.
That's a toughie.
10 and 2.
Your husband wouldn't
that's
be Tom
12,
Poston,
there.
Would it?
And where do you live?
Torrance. I'll take A.
What do I ask you? I didn't ask you what you want yet.
You talk too much, Evie.
Evie, we're going to have to get together again sometime soon and talk this over, all right? Yes.
What are you saying?
You're pointing to a commercial?
Okay, they're pointing to a commercial, Evie says.
Hello there. Yeah. Just time to say goodbye. You were just splendid. Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Goodson, Bill Tubman production. Get ready to match the star. Nipsey Russell. Pat Summer. Gary Berghoff. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson, and dear friends and gentle hearts. You all ready for this now? Are you ready?
All set.
Yeah.
What? I held it upside down. I had to write myself.
What does that say? Gulf Shores, Alabama?
Yes, I'm going to be the guest celebrity at the Shrimp Festival in Gulf Shores, Alabama, October the 1st through the 5th.
Who cares?
My mother cares.
Yes. Hello, Mom. All right, if you're all set, shall we begin this game?
Wow, yeah. I think that's a great
dying
idea.
Dying to talk to that lady who...
I'm wearing my glasses through this whole show because I think she's so cute I don't want to miss a minute of her.
Right. So let's say hello to Connie Simpson and Evie Phineas, ladies. Connie, is our current chance. She's won one game at $600, right? What are you going to do with $600?
Oh, I don't know.
You going to spend it or save it?
Oh, yeah, spend it.
You are. Good. That's good for the economy.
Right.
Okay. And as time expired last time, we had this long heart-to-heart talk with Evie Phineas. She said she's married and she's got two kids, and that was it. Listen, you know, when you get into a TV studio and you've never been here before and you see all the grid work and the lights and the monstrous cameras, it's a foreign environment and it makes one apt to feel a little bit insecure. And Evie is feeling a little insecure, but I just want you to know that we all love you, Evie. Don't we all love Evie?
Yes, yes.
See? Now, if you take a deep breath...
Evie, you don't see me blushing like that.
Not started like this.
Yes, he did. Now, if you just take a deep breath, it'll help calm you down. You do this, okay? That's it. And we'll start this game right after we do this message for you. Now, I push this button and ask Evie to make a selection.
B, please.
B, all right. Everybody plays. Here we go. Gloria works in a full-service operating room. Mm-hmm. At the same time the surgeon is taking out your appendix, Gloria is giving you a blank.
I'm with you, Evie.
What? Get the address.
What is a full-service operating room?
It's a full-service operating room. At the same time the surgeon is taking out your appendix, Gloria is giving you a blank.
I got it.
Oh.
I'll show you my answer, Evie, to help you out.
Nipsey's ready. Okay. Everybody all set? All right. Hold it now. We come to Evie. Gloria works in a full-service operating room. At the same time, the surgeon is taking out your appendix, Gloria is giving you a blank. What do you say, Evie?
Manicure.
A manicure, good. Yeah. So good. Yeah, she came up with a terrific answer.
Yeah, and they all agree with her. I thought it was an operating room. While she's taking out your appendix, she's giving you a nose job.
Oh. I see. That's a double operation.
Yes.
Okay, Brett?
Not only is Evie cute as a button,
yes,
she's smart as a whip.
Smart as a whip.
You know what I said, Evie? Manicure!
Manicure! Cutie as a button, smart as a whip. Hello, cutie.
I went into a full-service massage parlor recently, and they took out my appendix. I'm sorry, Evie. I really want... I love you. I said massage.
Massage. Well, no, massage is a possibility. All right, now we come here to this little girl. At the same time the surgeon is taking out your appendix, Gloria is giving you a, she said, manicure.
At the same time he's taking out your appendix, Gloria is giving you another one. That's full service. Oh, come on!
There's a touch of humor in her response. Don't you understand?
No.
The surgeon takes one out and Gloria says, here's another one. You don't... Okay.
No.
All right, Richard. Okay.
It was very good.
For explanation, please see appendix.
Right.
I said massage.
Massage. Right. So we have two massages, one manicure, and one leftover appendix. What do you offer?
Do you think I'd let you down, you cute thing? Do you? You know what I said? I said shampoo and set and manicure.
That's it. Okay, you got two out of that. Now, Connie, here's your first rounder. The Brett Summers Fan Club.
Uh-oh.
Just had their first annual convention. They held it in a blank.
This is an easy one.
I can't stand it.
Okay. Everybody ready? Okay.
Okay. Look, we ran out of music.
No, they didn't run out of
music. Okay,
no,
okay.
Just want to make sure you're ready. Now, Connie Simpson, the Brett Summers Fan Club just had their first annual convention. They held it in a blank.
Hairstyling shop?
A hairstyling shop.
What did the little devil say?
You mean because she wears so many wigs? Is that it?
Oh, she always looks nice.
She always looks nice. She said a hairstyling shop.
Oh.
Or beauty parlor, something like that. Well, Nipsey...
Well, the entire membership was there, and they held it in a phone booth.
That's it. Tell us about it, Brett. You were there.
Honey, we had the most wonderful time. We just sat around, and we chatted, and we said, one more for the road.
Yes.
Wow, there's only one place I would hold a meeting, and that's in a saloon.
Saloon. What'd you talk about? The old days, did you? That's nice.
The good days.
Nipsey is absolutely right. The entire membership was there, and they held it the most apropos place, a barn.
A barn.
Isn't that the worst answer you've ever heard.
Barns. A phone booth, a saloon, and a barn. Three different answers, and no beauty parlor for Connie Simpson. They held it in a beauty parlor, she said, or a hairstyling shop. What do you say?
I said they held it in a phone booth and there was room for four more people.
Okay, phone booth seems to be the response. No, they didn't. The audience is
You're
slowing up.
Zero,
don't ever hold a postmortem.
Enough left over to fill an agent's navel.
What do you say there, Richard?
I met her fan club, a delightful old man about 90. Geritol victim. Phone booth.
Phone booth.
Okay.
See, I wasn't so wrong.
Now, Fanny Flag.
Darling, I don't know why they're being so mean to you. She and I know the truth. In a bar.
Bar. That's right. Two saloons, but no phone booths, Connie. So at the end of round one, it's 2-0 in favor of Evie Phineas. And round two is coming up. But first this for you, friends. Here we are. And we're going to go to round two. At this moment, it's 2-0 in favor of Evie, who will now make a selection, A or B?
B, please.
B, all right. Now, there, Brett does not play, and Fanny does not play. Everybody else does.
Because we got the right answer.
That's right. The psychiatrist said to Marvin, how long do you think you've been a dog? And Marvin said, blank me and I'll tell you.
But I want that question again.
The psychiatrist said to Marvin, now, right. Tell me, how long do you think you've been a dog? And Marvin said, blank me and I'll tell you.
Oh,
well, that's good. Well, those are both nice answers, Evie. Let me see what
All
the brain
right.
has.
Well, that's
there.
Okay. That's very good. Now, over to Evie. The psychiatrist said to Marvin, how long do you think you've been a dog? And Marvin said, blank me, and I'll tell you.
Scratch me?
Scratch me? Behind the ears like that?
It don't matter.
It don't matter where you scratch him? My dog likes to be scratched right there behind the ears.
My dog.
Your dog likes it there? Well... I think we ought to change the subject. Nipsey, what do you say?
Well, I thought all good dogs would have a flea collar, so he said, walk me and I'll tell you.
Walk me and I'll tell you. Mm-hmm.
There's a few dog walkers there.
And Gary.
To my knowledge, the quickest way to a dog's heart is to feed him or reward him.
Feed me and I'll tell you. No scratch yet, Evie. What do you say?
Well, he was itchy to take a walk. Sorry, walk me.
Walk me and I'll tell you.
Yeah.
How long you think you've been a dog? Marvin said, walk me and I'll tell you.
When I give an answer.
She said, scratch me and I'll tell you.
Yes, I'm going to appeal to the judges because I think that's right. Pet me.
Pet and scratch, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. Sorry, I picked up one more, Evie. Now, Connie, it's up to you. The ball is in your court, as they say. You need 3 to tie, 4 to win. Dumb Doris, so dumb.
How dumb is she?
I'll tell you how dumb Dora is. At Easter time, she blanked the Easter eggs before she painted them. At Easter time, she blanked the Easter eggs
before she
painted them.
I love my answers so much.
Okay.
I want it to come as a total surprise.
All right, I don't want to see it. At Easter time, she blanked the Easter eggs, before she painted them.
Oh!
Change your mind.
Oh.
All right.
No, I want that.
That's good.
You change your mind again?
Yeah.
That's 3 times.
That was twice.
Okay, here we go. Connie Simpson. Dumb Dora is so dumb. At Easter time, she blanked the Easter eggs before she painted them.
Froze them?
Really? Froze them? Can you tell me why?
Well, she's too dumb to boil them.
Too dumb to boil them? So she did, you think the opposite, she froze them. You have a very logical mind.
No, I don't.
A losing logical mind.
On this show, that doesn't always work.
Right, that's right. You know, you could win with an answer like that on this weird kind of a program. Nipsey.
That wouldn't be too dumb. She fried them.
Fried them before she painted them. Brett.
I'm tearing up confetti. I love my answers so much.
Oh, you're getting ready to...
Dumb Dora! Laura was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
She ate them before she banged them.
Now that's dumb.
Whee!
That is dumb, Gary.
Well, I wrote it before she did.
She ate them. Now, Connie, you got to match everybody else to stay in the game. Elaine, we come to you.
I'm sorry. They copied me. Ate them.
Ate them. So that means Emmy wins the game. Come on down, Emmy. Congratulations. You got $100 now. All
right. You got to stay on longer.
What's that?
Nothing.
Okay. You know what she said? It means I got to stay a little longer. It means you got to go a little quicker. Connie's got $600 that she's going to take with her, and we congratulate you and you thank you. Goodbye. Now, here's a little message for you, and you can hurry right back to watch this lady. Oh. Here we are. This is Evie Phineas, who's won her first game. She's got her $100. Now she's going to try for over $5,000, and she's very anxious to do that. As you can well see, she's like a racehorse, champing at the bit in the stall, waiting for the starting gate to open. Are you ready? She's got a pad and pencil. She's going to write some of her answers. But right now, Evie, I point out to you that we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. The yellow blank.
Oh.
Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Now, whom do you call on here for a little assist?
Richard.
Richard?
The yellow brick road.
The yellow brick road. Okay, there's one.
Fanny.
Fanny?
The Yellow Rose of Texas.
The Yellow Rose of Texas.
Oh, God.
Okay, you got two now.
Brent.
How about the Yellow Submarine?
That's
the
it.
The Yellow Submarine. So you got, don't go away from me now. Stay right. I'll tell you what was said. The Yellow Submarine, the Yellow Rose of Texas, and the Yellow Brick Road. Do you want one of those? The Yellow Submarine,
or
the Yellow Brick Road, or the Yellow Rose of Texas. Are you doing? What dance is it you're doing
while
you're?
Help that child out.
Yes. What did you say? The Yellow Submarine.
The Yellow.
What? The one on top? Is that the one on top you want? Can't you read it?
I don't care.
You don't care. Submarine, the Yellow Brick Road, and the Yellow Rose of Texas.
We doubt it.
Okay.
Evie, would you like to see something in red?
Now, she pointed to the one on top, and that's the one we're looking for. And so let's find out. If it, whatever it is, no, she's looking for the Yellow Submarine. That's the one she pointed at. Let's find out if it's under the $100 response. The Yellow Rose of Texas is there, the one that Fanny gave you. Yes. All right. The Yellow Submarine is the one we're looking for. Let's see if it's under the... Will you stop twitching? No, you twitch all you want. Just... Time. The more you twitch, it arouses my libido, you see.
All the times he said those words to me.
I don't even know what that is. Anyway, we're looking for the Yellow Submarine. Let's see if it's under the $250 response. The Yellow Brick Road, the one that Richard gave you. The Yellow Submarine is the one that Brett gave you. Here's the last chance for the Yellow Submarine. Here is the $500 response.
Yeah! Yeah!
Terrific! Not yet. It's not. I'll tell you when it's over. Now, we got to go a little further here, Evie. You've won the 500. Yes, you can. Yes, you can now. Now, just get it all together now, because now you're going to try for $5,000. Okay, you ready? Now, don't goof up your mascara. You're ready, okay. Now, in order to collect $5,000, you have to match one celebrity head-to-head. Has to be exact. Time to choose one now, Evie.
Richard.
Richard, all right. Now, if you'll just turn around and face me here.
Center this way again, okay. If you get it right.
All right, you're stepping on my cable. That's all right. $5,000 question.
And a heart attack.
Yes. Listen, I tell you, if you're feeling a little nervous, just lean against me this way, you see. All right, Richard, here it is.
My boy, is he dumb.
Persian blank. Worth $5,000. Persian blank. Persian blank is, all right, he's finished. Now, you tell us what answer you want to give us, what you think will match his. Persian blank.
Cat.
Persian cat, she says, will match you.
I couldn't take it.
You couldn't take it? Mm. You're hoping it's wrong? Is that it?
Well.
All right. May we see it, please, Richard?
You're safe, Donald. There's two, and I thought of rug.
I thought of that.
You thought of that? But you didn't say it. Yeah. Well, maybe it's just as well. Well. But you're still a champ, and you're going to play another game. But before we do that, we got to do a little business. So, friends, here it is. Evie is weeping tears of joy because she's got $600, and she's going to join us next time we all get together, and we'll look forward to seeing you. How do you feel?
Great.
Gene Rayburn, Match Game 75. Oh, listen, next time we get together, these are the people you will be having the pleasure of your company with.
Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle.
Now, Gene Rayburn Match Game 75. Join us next time. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Gibson, Bill Chaplin production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations. Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin, Brett Summers, Gary Berghoff, Marianne Mobley, Richard Dawson, and Patty Deutsch as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now, here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn!
And Johnny Olson and friends, what's wrong? Everything okay? Okay. We greet you. Don't overdo it. You get your check anyway.
Oh, okay.
Now, for those of the benefit of you in the studio audience and you who are watching maybe for the first time, we have a little tradition. The celebrities always give a nice, warm greeting to the new kid on the block, and we welcome Dick Martin.
Yeah! Everyone, yeah, hey!
How are you?
Just fine, Gene.
We're delighted to have you here.
You
with
have
us.
A delightful show.
Thank you very much.
Have you seen it?
Yes. I wouldn't miss it.
Good for you.
Come on down.
He wouldn't miss it.
Okay, now let's say hello to our two players here, Evie Phineas and Susan Copperthwaite. Yay! Evie is our current champ. She's won one game, and she has $600 to her credit. And let's see, how many days have you been on now, Evie? I've forgotten. What is this, your third or fourth? Or second? Third.
Speak up, Evie!
This is your second day. Oh, well, you're a veteran.
No, it's...
Third.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Well, you're a veteran by now. It's his old hat, isn't it? Nothing to it, right?
Right.
Talkative rascal, isn't she? Now she's going to be challenged by Susan Copperthwaite, who will tell us a little bit about herself, if you would, please.
Okay, I'm married. I live in Simi Valley. I have two sons. And I enjoy needlepoint and growing plants, painting statuary. And I think you're terrific.
Thank you.
Well, that's one for me. Mine.
I do needlepoint, too.
Do you really?
Yes.
Isn't it fun?
Needlepoint is marvelous therapy, yes. You see what it did for me? Now, we'll start this game in a moment or so, but first we got this message for you. Here we go. Now, here we go. I will push this button, ladies, and reveal our two first-round questions. Ask Susan to make a selection.
I'll take B, please.
B it is. Here we go. Everybody plays. New game, folks. Albert said, I've found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank. I found the solution. Think about that, Susan. I found a solution to the energy crisis. It only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
You know.
Blank. Oh, I got it. I got it, honey.
Yes,
you use it all the time.
Right. Look, if he was the first one. All right, here we go.
He's smart, isn't he?
Call on Susan. Albert said. I found the solution to the energy crisis, but it only works in Washington, D.C. I've invented an automobile that runs on blank.
Tapes.
On what?
Tapes.
On tapes. Did you hear what she said? She says...
That's funny.
But there's an 18-minute gap between Los Angeles and San Francisco.
That's right. Car only goes for 18 minutes. Huh?
Yes.
She said tapes. Dick, what did you say?
Well, I'm afraid I said something a little more prosaic. Hot air.
Hot air. And we're not kidding, senators. Brett, what do you say?
You know what I say?
Well,
let you and me get married.
You did it! You did it!
Too. Hot air!
Hot air! Now, if you also said hot air, you got to think of something clever to say like they did before you say hot air and hold up your card, don't you?
I had something very clever, but it's too late now. You blew it for me. Hot air.
Hot air, okay. Hot air seems to have been the answer, Susan, although your answer of tapes is rather interesting. What do you say, madam?
I am so worried. I'm thinking like Brett now.
Really?
I said hot air.
Hot air. Has four orders of hot air. And now we come to Richard.
Tapes is a marvelous answer.
Yes, we say.
No, really, because it, you know, would not only get you where you're going, it would lie about the mileage. I happen to hear all those politicians speak, and I know the car would run on bull manure.
You may think he's doing jokes, but the fact is I read a long technical article about a guy who makes methane gas out of bull manure, and he ran a car in England, and you can do it out of garbage, out of chicken droppings, out of...
Exhaust!
Well, the only trouble is when you go for a drive in the country, your car keeps attacking cows.
Oh, that's right.
No.
That's enough. Now... You know, I really didn't see, I didn't see this until this moment. It says Fanny Flagg on your t-shirt.
Well, of course it does.
That's very cute.
Yeah, well, thank you.
How are you, Patty?
I'm just swell.
You gonna play the game with us?
I suppose.
Let the baby play.
Yes. What have you got there?
Well, coming from a sheltered home life and all, I said that it ran on bovine droppings.
Bovine droppings. Girl went to college. Okay, now we got your question, Evie. You ready for this? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday he tried to blank his ball. That's it. Oh, look at me, the warden just like, what am I? I'm just the middleman here.
Everybody look at the writers.
Yeah. The warden said, are you listening, Evie? The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball. Right. Okay.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, Marianne?
Yes, I'm thinking.
Oh, you
yes,
are thinking.
Right.
Okay.
Okay.
Dick, you're very quick. You have a quick mind, don't you?
I don't know whether.
May I just peek there? No. It's my show. Get your own trophy. You want to peek at answers there.
No, Dick, you're supposed to write something on the card.
Okay. The upper tier is finished. Are you fiddling around? What are you doing? Marianne, what are you? Okay, now she's ready.
It's a disaster anyway.
Evie Phineas will now give us a response. The warden said, I think that prisoner's been on the chain gang too long. Yesterday, he tried to blank his ball.
I'll say kiss. That's all I can think. Where?
Just a minute. Evie's a little insecure, so don't boo her. Did you see on yesterday's show or whatever it was? What was yesterday, John? Was yesterday Friday? Look on your sheet there and tell me what. Yesterday was Tuesday. Did you see her on yesterday's show?
Well, this must be Belgium.
Well, anyway, you heard her answer. Dick, what did you say?
I'd love to match hers, but I did say lift.
Tried to lift the ball. Okay. Brett, what did you say?
Well, I kind of went along with Evie because I'm crazy about her. I think
she's cute,
the
isn't she?
Cutest
yeah.
thing we've ever had on this show. I said, I said he tried to marry his ball.
Oh.
He was a desperate man. Yeah.
The chain would have been the yes.
Yes,
you Gary. Want to know it. Well, he was the guy towards the end with the limp. I said bounce his ball.
Tried to bounce his ball.
That was a good answer. Is that a good answer?
Try to pick up that 80 pie. I don't know how much of those things weigh. All right, Marianne, we're up to you.
I wish I could take it all back.
He tried to kiss his ball is what Evie said. Now, what did you say?
Oh, and I like your answer so much better. Well, you know how terrible food is.
Yes, yes. Well, I've never been in prison, but I hear it's pretty bad.
He tried to eat it.
Okay. All right, now.
Is there someone crazy like me in the audience?
That's right. There are a lot of crazy people in the world. What did you say?
And they're all out there.
I'm with Brett. Al Mario.
Tried to marry the ball, yeah.
And they were very happy, actually.
That's right.
Then sort of drifted.
Well, you know, you really had the same idea that Evie had because, yeah. you know, the...
All right, I didn't want any hanky-panky.
Right.
Get married first and then do what you like.
Okay, Fanny. Fanny, what do you say?
Well, my prisoner wasn't about to make a lasting commitment, just, you know, one of those things. Yeah. He tried to bet his ball.
Tried to bet his ball. Sorry, Evie, you didn't score with that. And as you can plainly see, we got another one of those tight games going here. And we'll continue with all this intense contest in a moment or so, but now this. Round two coming up. Now, ladies, Susan.
I'll give B another chance.
You're going to give B another chance, yeah. And vice versa.
You did so well with it.
Yeah, did well with it last time. The funeral director said, I just planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him. That's what the funeral director said. Planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him.
Oh, honey, I've got it.
Your brow is furrowed.
Oh, honey, it's an easy one.
Gary's first one finished. All right, upper tier is ready. You got
Dickie
it.
He was last.
Did you change your mind? Okay. All right, now we'll call on Susan. The funeral director said, I just planned a funeral for the most insecure man I've ever met. He made me promise to bury his blank with him.
Okay. Teddy bear?
Teddy bear. That'd be good. Yeah. That's a symbol of security, isn't it? Teddy bear is a symbol of security. I did an interview once with the actor Peter Bull. Is that his name?
He has thousands of teddy bears.
He has thousands. And he told me that many men went into war with their little teddy bears.
Well, because that's how we lost the British Empire.
It's a teddy bear is a security symbol. What did you say, Dick?
I said his wife.
Oh. Bury his wife with him. Well, that'd make you feel secure, wouldn't it?
I don't know where she was, anyway.
What did you say?
Well, honey, it kind of goes along with that, but not completely. He wanted to take his little blankie with
his
him.
Oh, his security blanket.
Wow.
Sure.
Security blanket is what she said. What do you say?
What do you think Radar O'Reilly would say? Of course, his teddy bear.
His teddy bear! Yes! Now, wait a minute. Didn't I see you in an episode of MASH involving a teddy bear?
Many, many episodes of MASH. You can see me at home involving a teddy bear.
How do you think his wife got pregnant?
That's enough of that. Now,
he spread honey all over the room.
He made me promise to bury his blank with him, and Susan said teddy bear. What do you say, Marianne?
Well, yes, they put his thumb in his mouth and then gave him his teddy bear.
Two for you. Do you offer that lady a teddy bear?
I wish I did. I wrote tapes. I said security blanket.
Security blanket, yeah. I guess that's the answer. Patty, did you have a security blanket as a child?
Yeah, and so did he.
And so did he, all right. So that's two for you. And now, Evie, you have to match two celebrities to stay in the game. Three will win your second game. The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man. And I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
What, sweetheart?
Could you repeat that, please?
Evie, are you confused? Well, I'll read it again for Evie's benefit. The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man, and I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank. Think about it for a second while they're finishing writing. They haven't even started writing
yet. Is the operative word electrician?
The electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man, and I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank. I don't know. I can't tell you what the operative word is, because that'd be leading you to an answer. I can only repeat it over and over again, 50 times if I have to.
Endlessly.
She is a little slow, you see.
Huh?
All right, now.
I'm with you. I don't have a clue, Evie.
I've answered it anyway. Put that right in the slot there. There we go. Now, Evie Phineas, the electrician said, don't say no until I've read the question.
Take your time.
Oh, okay. What you're trying to tell us is you've heard it three times, you haven't thought of an answer yet, huh? All right, I'll read it very slowly for you. You have green eyes, don't you? Very pretty.
Thank you.
Yeah. How many kids have you got?
Two.
Oh, how old are your kids?
I know that today.
Yes. Last time she didn't know how old her kids were.
10 and 2.
Good. All right. Now the electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man. Have you heard of him?
Yeah.
You have? Okay. And he said, I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
He's blank.
Said that, you see. I said he's blank. You have to say he's
blank. I can't say that. I can't.
Well, now wait a minute.
Okay.
You want to whisper something to me and I'll tell you?
I don't think I
can. Well, you know what you can say and what you've watched this show a lot. You know what you can say and what you can't say, don't you? Okay.
Okay.
All right.
I don't have an answer, so I'll just say, he's what?
I can't help it.
Now hold everything. Come on, step around. What? Not supposed to do what?
You're supposed to just say it.
Say it.
I forgot the question.
You forgot the question. All right, the question is, the electrician said, I have just examined the $6 million man. I don't know how to explain it, but he's... He's what?
No.
That's the answer we have to go with because the audience heard it and I heard it. She said he's sterile. Okay.
That's possible, isn't it?
That's possible. Yeah. Pay $6 million for a man and.
And that's it.
Would you show us your answer, please?
I'd say it's very close to sterile, really. It's short-circuited.
How about that? Well, I suppose that'd make him sterile. What did you say?
What was it she said?
She said, I don't know how to explain it, but he's sterile.
Good gravy, Marie. What a peculiar answer.
Yes, it is, isn't it?
Well, of course a man full of batteries would be sterile. Oh!
Evie,
I knew she would.
I knew. Why did you torture me that way? Why didn't you tell me right away?
I think he was scared.
That's right. If we uncover one more sterile man, you will tie the game then. What do you say?
Hmm?
Yes. Are you nervous?
Would you repeat the question?
Yes. I don't know how to explain it, but he's blank.
Sterile!
Sterile!
Well, you pay $6 million for a man and nothing works because he has a short circuit.
Short circuit. Okay.
Now, are you looking for another sterile man?
We're looking for another sterile man.
Bragging about it.
Her answer is.
It's an old war.
The question is.
I have just examined a $6 million man. I don't know how to explain it, but he's.
AC and DC.
Wait,
I see. Okay. Now we come to Fanny Flagg.
Yeah. Likewise,
ACDC. High score. Okay, this game ends in a tie, and we'll tell you what happens when we do have a tie right after we tell you about this. Now, here's what happens when we have a tie. You ready, Evie, to break the tie? Okay. We wipe the slate clean, and we push this button and reveal our two tie-breaking questions. One question for each. The one who scored the most will be the winner. Susan?
I'll take B again.
B again for the third time in a row, eh?
Gotta get right.
The Godfather didn't have any confetti. So when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window. Godfather didn't have any confetti, so when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window. All right. Waiting for the lady with the red hair.
Come on, Pat. Just don't take advantage
and
just
the
because
roots
you're
to
preggy.
Match. Now, Susan, the Godfather didn't have any confetti, so when the parade went by, he threw blank out the window.
It's got to be bullets.
He threw bullets.
Bullets.
She says... Took a handful of bullets, flung them right out the window. What do you say?
I said he threw his brother out the window.
He threw his brother. Oh, lovely fellow. Yes, you'd be a rascal. What do you say?
Well, he wanted to perk things up.
Yeah.
So he threw several bodies out the
several
window.
Several bodies. I love a parade. What do you say?
I said money.
Money. Okay, Marianne, money. What do you say?
I said bullets.
Bullets. There's one, Susan.
Spaghetti.
Spaghetti. Spaghetti. Spaghetti. So that's one for Susan. And now, Evie, we don't have a question for you now. What we have for you now is a commercial message. Are you ready for it?
Yeah.
All right, watch. I can't move because my mic is busted and it'll make a lot of noise, so I just say goodbye. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75. A Mark Cooks and Bill Tubman production. Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Marianne Mobley. Richard Dawson. And Patty Deutsch. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Friends and gentle hearts, are you all ready?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, but for what are you ready? Are you ready to play this game?
Yes.
And be brilliant and sparkling and witty and
yes,
gay?
Yes, friend and gentle heart.
Oh, all right. You don't want to be gay? You don't have to be gay, but say hello to Evie Phineas and Susan Copperthwaite. Evie is our current champion. She's won one game, and she has $600 to her. Does money make you feel secure?
Hmm?
Well, I'm glad you feel secure, Evie. And she's been challenged by Susan. We played one game to a 2-2 tie, and now we're in the tiebreaker. Susan has had her question. She scored one match, and we have a question for Evie. But before we do anything, we've got to do a little business, and this is the nature of the business we have for you. Okay, here we go with the second half of our tiebreaker. Evie, this is for you. Listen carefully. Dumb Dora was so dumb.
How dumb was she?
I'll tell you, I'm glad you asked how dumb she was. I'll tell you how dumb she was. She tried to get rid of her wrinkles by blanking her face. That's how dumb.
I hate that question.
Dumb Dora was so dumb, she tried to get rid of her wrinkles by blanking her face.
She tried to get rid of her wrinkles.
That's right. She had wrinkles on her face.
Right? And
she tried to get rid of them by blanking her face.
By blanking her face. I don't mean to sound like Evie, but
folks,
forget it.
This lady is dumber than Dumb Dora. Because if Dumb Dora were here right now, she'd come up with an answer immediately, just like that.
That shows how clever I am. I can't think of what the little devil would do.
Yes.
Okay.
Now think of an answer now.
Oh, I've got it, I think.
I can't spell.
I'll spell for you, honey. I can't think.
I can't spell. You're not going to be able to tell.
I
have no idea because I can't read it.
I will figure it out somehow. All right, everybody's finished. Here we go with Evie Phineas. Dumb Dora was so dumb. Would you like to know how dumb she was?
How dumb was she?
She tried to get rid of her wrinkles by blanking her face.
You're going to boo me, but I'm going to say sanding.
Sanding her face? Oh, sandpaper. Get rid of them that way, huh? Okay. You going to boo her? She says... Dumb Dora got rid of her wrinkles by sanding her face.
No, by unscrewing her face.
By unscrewing her face. All right. Now, Brett, what did you finally think of?
I'm so mad I didn't think of sanding. I may never show my answer. I said by shrinking.
By shrinking her face. All right, so far
don't we got... you boo me either. If they don't remember about my connections with the mafia, are they going to be in trouble in the parking lot?
All right, Gary Berghoff is up.
Is ironing a good question?
Ironing. That's the answer. Ironing her face. Every housewife in America knows that. Are you a housewife?
I don't even own an iron. What do you think
of
that?
I'm not even a housewife, and I know the answer. Are you a housewife?
I'm a housewife.
What did you think of?
Well, her answer was technically correct. They do sand faces to get rid of wrinkles.
That's right. I heard of that process.
But to show you what kind of housewife I am, I said ironing.
You said ironing. All right. We're up to Richard. What did you say, Richard? She says to get rid of her wrinkles by sanding her face.
Yeah, well, ironing's all right, but the wrinkles will come right back.
Oh.
Not if you
Well, actually, starch them.
What I do is
sprinkle.
This is what Brett does to her face. You starch it.
You starch the face.
Yeah.
I see. Okay.
Unless you get caught in the rain and then.
Yeah. Yeah. So now, Patty, we need one sandpapered face to achieve a tie here.
May I be excused?
No.
I said ironing her face.
Ironing! So Susan wins the game. Congratulations. Okay. Evie, we're sorry to see you go. You're a nifty kid and a peachy dancer, I guess. What are you going to do with your $600, Evie?
Buy a house and a car and... Yes, sir.
Evie Phineas, thank you. Goodbye, my dear. Oh, boy. Somebody better tell her about inflation. You can't buy a house and a car.